Teabagging has been around in online gaming for a long time, but now gamers are beginning to get banned for it. So as a Christian gamer, this leaves me wondering, what does God think of all this? Does the Bible say anything about teabagging? That's why in this video, I'm going to do my best to answer the question, should Christian gamers teabag in video games? What is up, gamers? My name is Susie, and in this channel, we connect God and gaming in a way that entertains and encourages and equips gamers to become all that God's created them to be. So I encourage you, whether you're exploring faith for the first time or looking to grow in your faith, hey, consider subscribing to this channel, hit that thumbs up, turn the notifications on. It helps the video so much, but also link in the description below. Come join our live stream. We have conversations like this. We share lots of laughs, play lots of games, but all while having conversations that will help gamers like you grow in their faith. We got a big topic to cover today, all about, yes, teabagging. Let's talk about it. Friends, well, if you have not heard just yet, the teabagging topic is taking the internet by storm. It is everywhere right now. And the reason that's happening, if you haven't heard, it's a little controversial. It's a little crazy, but actually people are beginning to get banned in video games. Let me show you real quick. People in literally Valorant by Riot, people are getting banned from teabagging video games. It already happened in another Apex Legends tournament. Literally, a player teabagged his own teammate for fun, and not only was he disqualified, but the entire team was disqualified. And now it's becoming a bigger issue, not just because of the teabagging issue itself, which we're going to talk about obviously in this video, but people are even beginning to compare teabagging in a video game to sexual assault. Now, I'm not going to cover that topic in the video, but if you want me to, let me know in the chat right now or in the comments below this video. Do you want me to make a separate video on my thoughts? Is teabagging sexual assault? I'd love to dive into that question. But in this video, I'm really going to cover things from the perspective of, should a Christian gamer teabag? Now, I want to be very clear, we're not going to talk about from the perspective of, is teabagging toxic? Because some people might correlate that also to the principle of, you know, meleeing a dead body, shooting a dead body while it's on the ground. We're not coming at this from the perspective of, is it toxic? Do people just need to be nicer to each other in PvP? That's also another separate conversation, which I can make another video on if you guys want. This is coming directly at the topic of, should Christian gamers teabag? Does the Bible say anything about teabagging itself? And as Christian gamers, should we be partaking in such behavior? I'm ready to dive right in, friends, because this has been something that's been around for a long time. Believe it or not, before we can really answer that question, we have to define, what is teabagging? A lot of people, believe it or not, do actually not know what teabagging is, especially if you're in the younger generation, maybe you're Gen Z. I actually didn't even really realize this till researching. Some people don't actually know what it is. Some people literally do not know what it is. And in today's world, a lot of people actually understand teabagging simply just to be a sign of disrespect. Simply just to be a sign of like, oh, get wrecked, I'm better than you at the game. Which is very similar to, you know, meleeing a dead body on the ground, shooting a dead body in the ground, which is very, very common in the FPS genre. And a lot of people actually don't even fully understand where teabagging came from. The reality is, especially in some FPSs today like Valorant, you can actually turn on a setting where when you die, your dead body doesn't stay on the ground. So for a lot of people, especially younger generation, I'm 31 years old, average age of a hardcore gamer being 33, 34 years old, a lot of people are just crouching up and down over nothing. And so for them, they've grown up crouching, but not over a body, which we'll get to in a second here. And it's important to understand how people mean it today versus what people meant it back then. Because some people might say, well, isn't teabagging just the same thing as the melee? And the reality is that no, unfortunately, it is not the same thing. Also, although they do mean to have the aspect of disrespect, they do mean to have the aspect of I'm better than you, get wrecked. They do share that meaning, but they also have a very different meaning if you understand the actual origin and definition of what teabagging is. Now, again, we're gonna get into this because I think it's an important topic for us to talk about. I did some research, and some of you already know, but I found an actual definition literally brought to us from UMass College in the University of Massachusetts, an actual paper released from UMass. This was their definition. First popularized within Halo 2. Come on, we got any Halo 2 people in the chat? Let me know if you're a Halo 2 fan. I'm a Halo fan. Let me know in the comments below. Did you grow up playing Halo 2. First popularized within Halo 2 multiplayer competitive matches. Here's a definition. Teabagging is a controversial practice where the player's avatar, so your character, repeatedly crouches over a defeated player's body. Now, some people might know that, but they might not know the origin. What are they actually doing it for? It's actually to simulate, here's where it gets nasty, rubbing his or her genitals over the avatar's body. And if you really played FPSs back in the Halo 2 or the Modern Warfare 2 days, let's just be as honest as possible. It wasn't just crouching over the person's body. Let's get real. It was crouching over the person's face. Let's just get it out there because we can't answer the question of should Christians teabag if we don't understand the origin of what it means. Here's the deal. That's what it was, friends. That's what teabag was, and that's what teabag is. And here's the deal. There's also room for some argument of, well, does the origin of where it came from really matter? And here's the deal. I would actually give some leeway in that conversation because there are certain things in the world that maybe started off with a negative origin, but have been turned into something good. Some of you might not know, for example, take the Christmas tree. You might not know, but the Christmas tree actually started off as a pagan practice. It was also used in the time of the Romans. They would use things similar to a Christmas tree actually to worship and celebrate the god of Saturn. That was the origin. But nobody does that today, right? You're not thinking about the god of Saturn when you go to Walmart and buy a fake Christmas tree or chop one down with your little son, Jimmy. And a lot of people would say like, hey, that's the origin, but no one really focuses on that today. And there, I would agree. So some people might be able to say, well, if that principle applies to the Christmas tree, can't we apply that to teabagging? I mean, dude, a lot of us, we're not even crouching over bodies anymore. We're just kind of doing in the distance just to symbolize like get wrecked. And I would have leeway for that type of mentality if it wasn't for this principle. Average age of a hardcore gamer being 33 to 34 years old, which is right in my ballpark of age. I'll tell you, we grew up in a world where teabagging was exactly the definition that I just read to you. And if we, people of my age, make up the average hardcore gamer, and that's what we believe about teabagging, then it's tough to say that the origin is no longer in play, because if the average age of people believe that to be the origin and the meaning, then the origin is still very, very much in play. If we're talking about people getting banned in Valorant because people are even asking the question, is teabagging sexual assault, which I'm not saying that it is, but if that conversation is even being had, that means that people are still associating teabagging with something sexual, very much meaning that the origin is still very, very much in play. So for me, the origin doesn't matter, only takes an effect if people still aren't focusing on the origin, which they are today. Which leads us, friends, to the big question. Okay, we've talked about teabag, talked about what it is, but should Christian gamers do it? Again, we're not covering this from a, is it toxic to like melee a body and just being rude to other players? That's not the point of this video. Should Christians, should followers of Jesus, who are doing our best to follow the standards of the Bible, be teabagging? Now, here's the deal. I'm not trying to come at you, friends. I'm not trying to come at us from a perspective of, oh, I'm better than you and I'm perfect and I'm righteous. Believe me, I've made my fair share of mistakes in my life. But I know a lot of people are wondering, Susie, have you ever teabagged? And I got a confession, friends. I have done a lot of that in my old FPS days. I wore my Halo shirt for a very specific reason. When I was a teenager playing Halo 2, bro, Halo 2, I'm not gonna lie, was kind of toxic. Like, friends, if you look up Halo 2 in the dictionary, like, you're just gonna see this picture right next to it. Like, back in the Halo 2 days, like, you might have done more teabagging than you did shooting of your gun. Like, it was insane. So I'm not trying to come at you. I'm not trying to come at you from the angle of like, oh, I'm better than you. Like, I was a hardcore Halo 2 player, and bro, I'm not gonna lie, I have done my fair share of teabagging. If I managed to get a quad shot off in Halo, the most advanced double shot, the most advanced button combination in the whole game, it was an 8-button combination that needed to be done perfectly in time in a matter of 2 seconds while still aiming at your face. Bro, if you got quad shotted, bro, I hate to admit it, but you got the ultimate teabag, bro. The ultimate teabag was when you literally did that until their teammate came over and killed you and then teabagged you because you were teabagging his teammate, and the teabag cycle just continued over and over and over. So I'm not coming at you like I'm better than you, because let me tell you, I'm not. I've made my fair share of mistakes in my life. I was a teenager. I did a lot of things and teenager that I really wish I hadn't done. But here's the deal. Just because I did something doesn't mean that it's right. When we are getting our standard of how we should behave, we have to look to what the Bible says. We have to look to what God says. So here's the deal. In order to answer this question, should Christians teabag in video games? Because I know for a lot of us, like, man, we might think it's lighthearted. We might be like, ah, man, gamers are getting soft and getting offended over everything. I want to talk about from a biblical perspective, but to help us do that, I want to bring this on the screen. This is ESRB. If you guys have never really heard the true definition of ESRB, it's the Entertainment Software Rating Board. This is what rates all video games, the content that's in them. You've seen this. It's on, I'm pretty sure, every single video game like to ever exist. And here's the deal. Many games have ratings, and in that rating, it gives you the type of content that is allowed in the game, meaning that anything outside of this content is not allowed in the game. And here's the deal. I really respect the ESRB, and here's why. Because over the years, it has not changed. The standards of what's allowed in the games have not changed. What has been allowed in teen games has relatively stayed the same of what has always been allowed in teen games. But if you watch movies, you got movies that are rated PG, rated G, rated PG-13, rated R. You might notice that over the years, man, 15 years ago, when I was playing Halo 2, the things that were in rated R movies back then are in rated PG-13 movies today. Why? Because the standards of what's allowed and not allowed have drastically changed. The things that they're allowing in PG-13 movies are like pretty hardcore today. But here's why I respect the ESRB, and here's why this conversation ties into everything. Because the standards of what is allowed in a T for T game has not changed. But what people do nowadays is causing almost all games to be rated M for mature. So the standards haven't changed. People's choices and how they behave have changed. So T for T games are the same, but people are living an M for mature type of life. The standards haven't changed. The way people behave has changed. And as followers of Jesus, we need to look to a standard that does not change. And that is the Word of God. The Entertainment Software Rating Board does not get to determine the behavior of a follower of Jesus. The Bible does. So when we look to answer this question, that has to be our standard. So what I want to do is I want to show you what I believe is an important standard that I've really been looking through and answering this question for myself. This is Ephesians 5, verse 3. It says, "But among you, there must not be even a hint, not even a hint of sexual immorality or any kind of impurity or of greed, because these are improper for God's holy people." Now, friends, here's the deal. I never want to be that Christian guy that's like legalistic or super uptight or, bro, let's not make a bigger deal out of this than it is. I never want to be that guy. I never want to be that guy because I think that unfortunately sometimes the Christian faith, we can be that guy. And I know that it's just a video game and I know that it's just fun, but here's the deal. I mean, we read the definition. Literally defined by UMass College in Massachusetts, it is to repeatedly crouch over a defeated player's body, simulating rubbing his or her genitals over the avatar's body. Now, here's the deal. I know that when you teabag someone in a video game, you're not actually like mentally picturing yourself doing that. You might not even really mean it to do that. But what it represents is something obvious, I think most of us would agree, is very inappropriate. And when I read this verse, it challenges me in my life to have not even a hint, not even something small. You might be like, ah, bro, why are we making a big deal out of this, man? Man, our standards are too high. I want to do my best to live my life according to the Word of God. And here's the deal. If I had done a better job in my life of fleeing from every hint of sexual immorality in my life, I would have saved myself a lot of pain. a lot of hurt. And here's the deal. I'm not saying that like, oh, teabagging is the gateway drug to like way worse things. No, that's not what I'm saying either. But what I'm saying is every single one of us, we need to analyze our hearts, analyze our behavior. Does representing rubbing your genitals on someone else's body in a video game, does that represent our faith very well? Does that give off even a hint of sexual immorality? Here's the question that I know sometimes sounds pretty cheesy when you ask it. Let me tell you, I believe with all my heart that if Jesus were alive here on the earth, he's alive in heaven, but if he were walking around as a person, I believe with all my heart he'd play video games with you. I believe he would play FPSs with us, and I believe he'd be 360 no-scoping everyone and just destroying you, top-fragging all day long. I want to ask myself the question, after Jesus killed your FPS, do you think he would walk over and teabag you? Because I gotta be honest, I don't think that he would. And the way that Jesus behaves, that's how I want to align my life. I don't want even the smallest thing to hinder people from seeing the good that God has done in my life. And friends, I'm not asking us, are we perfect? I'm not asking us, have you ever made a mistake? But I'm asking us this question. Are you doing your best to live in a way that is proper for God's holy people? The rest of the world might want a teabag and they might not think it's a big deal. But there are certain behaviors that are improper for God's holy people. So really, when it comes down to the question, do I think Christians should teabag people in video games? I know it's just a game. I know it's not real. I know it's just a joke. I understand all of that. But I want to live my life in a way that represents my faith in everything that I do. And believe me, I've done things that have not represented my faith well. But I don't want to make those things a habit that I do on purpose over and over and over again. I want to flee from even the smallest hint of sexual morality. I want to flee from even the smallest hint of things that do not represent who I claim to follow very well. I don't just want to follow him so I can go to heaven. I want to follow his behavior. And if Jesus wouldn't do it, then neither do I. Well, friends, hope you're blessed and encouraged by this video. Obviously, those were my thoughts, but hey, let me know your thoughts in the comments below. Should Christian gamers teabag in video games? I'd love to hear from you, but I want to say thank you for watching this video, but also, again, join our live streams. I'd love to engage in this conversation with you live, hang out with you, get you a part of our community. Also, Discord link in the description below, but also want to say a massive thank you to everyone that supports this stream, whether it's on Twitch or on Patreon. Thanks for making it possible for us to continue to share God's love with gamers around the world and create content that's connecting God and gaming, all to uplift and build the gamer. Friends, thank you so much. I appreciate you. We'll catch you in the next one.